Hello students, welcome back to Dr. Food Feeder Chat channel where we are exploring the world of business management with Dr. Noor. Today I am here to teach you a very important function of management, that is leading. You must be knowing being a leader is very very important, right? And without leader no activity will go on properly. Same way, though in an organization managers are there, manager will take care of everything. In spite of that, if manager is not able to become leader, the effectiveness will not be there. Maybe he is a good manager, but he is not a good leader. The good leader may not be a manager, but he is a good leader. Correct? So, that is why a very important function of management leading, and it is one of the elements of direction. As I told you, in direction, you have supervising, then you have leadership, communication and motivation, all these come under direction. So today we are discussing about leader. Who is a leader? What skill a leader will have? And what is the difference between manager and a leader? Why we say all leaders are correct, may not be manager, but all managers should be a leader. So why is it so? Maybe leader may not be a manager, but why a manager should be a leader? So we discuss all these things in this video. So before I start with that, let me ask you, have you subscribed to my channel? If not, please subscribe it today itself and keep watching my videos, keep sharing my videos, keep liking my videos and keep writing comments. I will reply each and every comment given by you. So, this is my humble request for the growth of my channel and to develop more videos and inculcate my material skills in you. This is what I want you guys to do. Hope you will do that. With that belief, let me go on with today's topic, leading. Okay, so here what you'll be learning. So let me slowly tell you. So what are the topic we are discussing here? So in this chapter, we'll be learning about leading as a management function. As I told you, we are transitioning to principles of management under the leading. So leading as a management function, then leadership and vision, leadership trait, then classical leadership style, the leadership behavior. So all these things I'll be teaching you one by one. So today let me start with the meaning of leadership first. Yes. So leading as a management function. So let us see what happens here. Yeah. So leading as a management function, it involves leading is the act of influencing others. So leading is all about influence. Managing is all about managing, right? Same way, leading is all about influencing. See, I may not have to warn you. If you don't do, I'll punish you. Just looking at me, it will feel like doing. Looking at me, it will feel like giving his best. That is what a leader will do. Let me give you an example of some leaders before I start the meaning of leadership. Let me give you an example. When I talk about leader, which leader comes to your mind? Yes? Maybe Mahatma Gandhi, correct? We call him as a Babu, leader of the world. He's under his leadership, correct? So we worked on gaining the independence, making the country independent, free from British. So he's the best leader you must have come across. Then Nelson Mandela, Mother Teresa, correct? These are the leaders which come to my mind when I talk about leadership. Don't you think they all are inspired people? See, Mahatma Gandhi, did you see? People will not be scared of him. He was so humble, correct? So simple looking person. Looking at his personality, no one will be scared. But still, we all followed him, correct? When he said the principle of non-violence to be adopted, all of us adopted it. Why? Because we got influenced by him. So leader is one who will not want people, who will not blaspheme people. Do this, otherwise I'll harm you. No, leader is one who inspire people. Leader is one who influence people. Mother Teresa influenced thousands of people, lakhs of people. Nelson Mandela influenced lakhs of people. Mahatma Gandhi influenced lots of people. Correct? You just name, there are so many leaders, even in the corporate sector. You take an example of Bill Gates. What example he has set as a leader. All these people have influenced us. Till now, any motivational talk by by them, we really love to hear and learn from them how we can become better human, how we can become better manager, how we can become better leaders. So that is what is leadership. So leading is a management factor. So leadership is an act of influencing others to what a leader wants to do. The second one, leading or leadership is one of the many functions of manager. Many functions. The manager will do planning, organizing, staffing, directing, controlling, all these he will do. Along with that, he will do this function also, that is called as leading. Then leadership is a process of influencing a group toward achieving a goal. See, let me take an example of Mahatma Gandhi, the leader. What was the goal he had? Making India free from British. With that goal, he made full country to work on that goal. That is the power of leadership. Correct? So influence people to achieve the goal. And a leader influence and encourage employees to attain high level of performance. Correct? A mediocre employee who can achieve only 10%, if a good leader is there, a good leader can make him achieve 90%. That is the power of leadership. Manager can't do that. Manager can increase from 10% to 10%, but leader can make from 10% to 90%. That is the power of leadership, what I'm talking about. The leader influences and encourages employees to attain high level of performance within the limitations of available resources, skill, and technology. So the leader influences and encourages employees, right, to attain high level of performance. Correct? Maybe the 10% is his ability, but he is able to do 90%. Correct? The same thing happened to India. The Britishers were so strong, we were so scared. How are we going to get independence? We got it. We fought for 200 years, but ultimately we achieved it. So that is the power we are talking about. Correct? So the leader influences and encourages employees to attain high level of performance within the limitation of available resources, skill and technology. Maybe skill is limited, maybe technology is limited, absolutely no problem. Inspiration is at the high level, influencing at the high level, even a mediocre employee will give his best if the leader is good. That is why today all the organizations, success depends upon leader. Who is the leader? Any organization you take, the success of the organization is only the credit. Always goes to leader. The leader has set the system in such a way, the leader has influenced the people in such a way, today the organizations are completely different and today the organizations are really doing very, very well. That is the power of leader. So leading as a management function, this is what you should know. So it helps you to influence people, it helps you to achieve the goal, then correct leading or leadership is one of the acts that what a leader has to do. And maybe the resources are limited, but that can be doubled if you have good leadership and happiness. So that is what we are talking about here. So let us see the vision. What do you mean by vision? You come across these words, right? Leadership, vision, right? What vision, correct? When Microsoft was started, what vision the leader had? Every leader will have a vision. Like Mahatma Gandhi had the vision, making India free from British. Correct? So same way, now our present Prime Minister Narendra Modi, he is also a very inspirational leader and people like him, the one man who brought back the party to power and able to remain as Prime Minister with full, correct? With full power, right? Without any coalition for 10 years. Ruling the country is not a joke. That proves how good leader he is. So let me see his vision, making the present vision of our Honorable Prime Minister is Atmanirbhar Bharat, right? He wanted to have a self-dependent India. He wanted to have an Atmanirbhar Bharat. That is what our Prime Minister is working on. That is what is called as leader. Our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi, vision Atmanirbhar Bharat. Mahatma Gandhi, leader, and vision was a democratic country. So look at each leader will have vision and they work only toward that vision. What I want to see India in the next 10 years, next 20 years. So that is what it is. So leadership and vision. The leader's job is to create vision. Yes. Leader's job is to create vision. That is what, correct, very, very important. You just have to tell people, make them visualize what they have to do. The leader's job is over. Mahatma Gandhi said, non-violent, can give us independence, please work on it, practice this. People believe it, and people started following it. That is what a leader does. Leader's job is to create vision. That is what the Robert L. Swigert had told. A vision, what is a vision? Vision is a mental image. Vision is mental image. Where I'll be after 10 years. It's a mental image I can have. Correct? Where my Microsoft company will be after 10 years. Correct? That's a vision. Where India will be after 10 years. It's a vision you should have. Vision is a mental image of a possible and desirable future state of organization. Possible and desirable future state of the organization. The best visions are both ideal and unique. The best visions are both ideal and unique. The best vision should be very ideal and also it should be very unique, correct? Right? It should be very unique, very different. Then only the vision will have its value. If what everyone is doing, you want to do the same thing, then you are not going to sustain for longer. So that's very, very important. The great leader imagine an ideal future for their organization. The great leader imagine an ideal future for their organization. This is then something after 10 years where we will be. Right? Country where they will be. And goes beyond ordinary and beyond what others may have thought possible. So two metaphors reinforce the important concept of vision, like jigsaw puzzle and client projector, right? So you can compare leadership with the jigsaw puzzle or maybe a client projector, where we just try to foresee ourselves where they will be, right? And which is unique, which is different, which is challenging. But with good leadership time, they should be able to get success. So that is what is leadership, right? Vision. Now, let us talk about what do you mean by leadership trait? What trait a leader will have? See, there is no, whenever we talk about leadership trait, no, there is no uniformity in the thought here. Because each person has given their own trait for leader. Some people say leader physically look very healthy, very tall, very good physique, then only look like a leader. Then what about Mother Teresa? What about Mahatma Gandhi? They didn't have disability, but they were very good leaders. Correct? So, there is a lot of debate here. Some people say this should be there. And some people will say, no, it is not required. So there is no uniformity in their thought approach. But all overall, these things matter to become a leader. So some of the points where people have agreed, yes, these are the things the leader will have. So that I am discussing you here as a part of leadership. So let me take you to the very important topic here, the characteristics of leader. So by Peterson and Plowman, they have given that 18 most desirable, right? More desirable characteristics of leader. Please make a note of it. I told you earlier also, there is no hard and fast rule that these are the attributes and traits of the leader. But many people have lot of defense over there, a lot of criticism and appreciation over there. Each one of them have given their own set of attributes of leader, a trait of leader, which is also called as trait theory of leadership. But nothing like that is permanent. Nothing has proved that these are the things important. As I told you, physical qualities are very important. But you look at these two examples of Mahatma Gandhi and Mother Teresa, it will not hold good. Like that, each one of them have got their own way of giving it. Everything has got its own drawbacks as well as advantages as well as disadvantages. But anyhow, traits of leadership, make a note of traits, are nothing but characteristics of leader. Or it is also called as attributes of leader. Characteristics or traits of leader, given by Peterson and Plowman. Have given this, Peterson and Plowman have given 18 attributes desirable in leader. According to them, these 18 points should be there in a leader. Then only leader will be a successful one. And these 18 attributes, they are broadly classified in some four categories, right? They are broadly classified in some four categories, right? 18 into, we have been classified in four categories. The first one is physical quality. What is physical quality? Health, vitality, and endurance, right? Physical quality, health, very important, right? Then vitality, then endurance, right? So, physical quality, health, vitality, and endurance. Very important quality of a leader, which give him success. Then second set is a personality attribute, that is the psychological attribute, the behavioral attribute, not the physical attribute. It is called a personal attribute or personal magnetism. A person should have a charismatic personality. He should be like a magnet. People should get attracted to him. maybe because of his physical qualities or maybe his leadership ability or maybe his oratory skills, he speaks so well, everyone feels like following him on their own. That is personal magnetism. Cooperativeness, very cooperative person, he helps all of us. Then enthusiasm, very important. A leader cannot be boring, a leader cannot be lazy, a leader has to be very enthusiastic person. Then a very important trait is ability to inspire. If you are not, see Gandhiji, you wouldn't have inspired us, you wouldn't have adopted the non-violent path. Mother Teresa, when she started treating the leprosy patient, people feel that leprosy, we were blaming that it is going to pass from one person to another. Is it not so? Then why Mother Teresa did not get infected? So people started getting inspired and they think that we can support. It is not that we don't get the disease. So ability to inspire. Then persuasiveness. How good you are in persuading people to perform what you want them to do. Forcefulness. Sometimes you have to force people to complete the task. Because when time is being given and you have to finish the task, you should have ability of forcefulness and tact, very important, tact, that is on time, perfection. Correct? Personal attribute, he should have personal magnetism, cooperativeness, then enthusiasm, ability to inspire, persuasiveness, forcefulness, and tact. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 attributes and the personal attribute, and we had 3 in physical, correct? So 10 over, so another 8 language in you now. Character, the third one is character, very important to learn. If you yourself have so many crimes on you and you have done so many mistakes before, how can you become a leader? Correct? Usually we don't accept such people, those who have very bad background, it's going to influence their behavior. Character is very important. A leader should be honest. Leader should be an honest person. He should be known for his integrity. He should be known for his humanism. He should be known for self-discipline, stability, and industry. So the character attributes of integrity, humanism, self-discipline, stability, and industry. So the character attributes of integrity, you can have humanism, or self-discipline, or stability, or industry. Very important character attributes, right? As a character, the leader should be honest. He himself keeps on telling lies and asking people to be speak only truth will not make sense. He himself is quite non-violent person and asking people to have peace and go the non-violent route, people will not follow. First, you should become what you are telling. Character is very, very important, and here you have this integrity, humanism, self-discipline, stability, and industry. So these are the 4 attributes we have here, which differentiate a common man with leader. The next you have intellectual qualities, very, very important. A leader has to be intelligent, because a leader should be a good planner. The leader should be a foreseer. Today I'm starting the business, I should be able to see my business next 20 years from now. Then only I will be called a visionary or I will be called a leader. So you should have a basic intellect level, right? Intellectual qualities, mental capacity to think, mental capacity to plan, mental capacity to implement, then ability to teach others. A leader should be a very good teacher. He should be able to teach others and he should have qualifications as well as he should be able to know how to solve the problem. So scientific approach to solve the problem. A leader should always not go for rule of thumb method to solve the problem. He should know the scientific method of solving the problem that makes him a very good leader, very successful leader. So usually a leader is supposed to have this trait which make a leader a very successful one. So hope you are able to understand them. All the 18 attributes or characteristics of leader given by Peterson and Plowman. Correct? These 18 attributes will differentiate a common man with a leader. And this also we call it as trait theory of leadership, which believes that leaders are born. Leaders cannot be made. Because they are born with these abilities, then only they are leader. These abilities cannot be learned. They get it by virtue of their birth. So that is what the theory talks about it, and this is the trait they should have. Very important, topic today we have discussed, students. I told you who's a leader, meaning of leadership, then why leader is important. Then we discuss leadership as a management function, and we also discuss about the leadership trait, correct? Leadership and vision we discussed, and I also taught you about the 18 traits what a leader should have that make a leader a very successful one. Hope you understood this. So that's all I have today. The next lab, I'll be continuing with very important topic, leadership style. So what style a leader will follow, that I'll load in the next class. Till then, keep watching my videos, keep seeing my videos, keep commenting, keep liking, and please subscribe to my channel if you have not done it. I believe you are going to do that. So with that, let me end the class today. Let me continue the leadership style in the next class. Till then, take care.